Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar. In this video, we are going to deploy Matrix Beat on Kubernetes cluster. You will get system level CPU usage, memory, file system, disk IO, and network IO statics. You can visualize all the statics in Kibana dashboard. After implementing Matrix Beat on Kubernetes environment, you can get the statics about your Kubernetes environment, like how many nodes are running in Kubernetes environment, total deployment, desired port, available port, unavailable ports, along with CPU and memory usage by nodes. I am going to use Matrix Beat Helm chart to deploy the Matrix Beat on Kubernetes cluster. This Matrix Beat Helm chart is dependent on Kube State Matrix. Kube State Matrix will collect all the Kubernetes cluster level metrics like deployment matrix, ingress matrix, jobs matrix, node level matrix, persistent volume matrix, service level matrix, etc. You can enable or disable desired matrix in values.yml file. Let's start to implement Kube State Matrix. I am going to install Kube State Matrix with default value in separate namespace called elk. Kube State Matrix has been deployed. Kube State Matrix pod is running. Now let's deploy Matrix Beat. Again, you can modify values.yml file according your Elasticsearch configuration. This is my customized values.yml file. Matrix Beat plugins comes with many modules. You can get a complete list of modules along with the help on their website. In this demonstration, I am using the Kubernetes module and these are metric set. I am going to collect the information about the container, node, pod, system and volume. Kubernetes module use the kubelets to connect and collect the metric set data on each node in a cluster by using port number 10255. We are using the processor to enable the cluster level matrix. We are continue with Kubernetes module and this time we are using event matrix set. Next module we are using system. In system module we are using matrix set, CPU, load, memory, network, process and process summary. We are collecting all the processes that are running on system and we are filtering all the process by top 5 CPU and memory. We are continue with system module and this time we are using file system and FS state matrix set. We are using the processor to filter or create a condition. We are dropping all the events or statics to these mount point like sys, cgroup, proc, dev, etc, host and lib. We are sending all the collected metrics to Elasticsearch. Let's figure out Elasticsearch address. If you are following my videos to set up the Elasticsearch in Kubernetes cluster, I'm using the Helm chart to set up the Elasticsearch. I am using this Helm chart. Let's get more information about this chart in our environment. Let's list down ingress configuration for Elasticsearch. Let's describe ingress controller for the Elasticsearch. This is address of Elasticsearch in our Kubernetes cluster. Next one, we are defining the configuration file for kube state matrix. Metric feed is dependent on kube state matrix to collect the Kubernetes cluster statics. These metric set start with state like state node, state deployment, state replica set, state pod, state container. We are sending all the kube state matrix to Elasticsearch. We are running one replica set. This is the path on host machine where metric bit write the data. This is the image we are using for metric bit. This is liveness health check for the container, and this is readiness health check for the container. These are cluster role. These are default values for metric bit deployment. Let's go ahead and deploy metric bit on cluster. I uploaded my customized values.yaml file on the Kubernetes workstation. I am going to install metric bit in elk namespace. Metric bit has been successfully deployed. Metric bit ports are getting ready. All the ports are running now. Before looking the metric bit metrics in Kibana dashboard, we require to enable metric bit dashboard on each container. We also required Kibana address to load metric bit dashboard. If you are following my video to set up the Kibana, you can get the Kibana address by using simple steps. Get a list of ingress in elk namespace. Describe the Kibana ingress. This is the address of your Kibana dashboard. Now connect ports one by one. We are inside the container and run this command to load the metrics dashboard in Kibana. It is loading the dashboard. Your Kibana should be run and reachable from this container. Metric bit dashboard has been loaded in Kibana dashboard. Exit from this container and connect the second container. Run again the same command to load the dashboard. Metric bit dashboard has been successfully loaded in Kibana dashboard. Exit from this container. Now look at metric bit metrics and statics in Kibana dashboard. This is my Kibana dashboard. Go to the dashboard and these dashboard created or generated by metric bit plugins. There are many dashboard available for different platform. You can select the dashboard according your requirement. For example, this is metric bit system dashboard for the system metrics. Let's open it. Basically, this dashboard provides a complete overview about your Kubernetes cluster environment. How many nodes or hosts in your Kubernetes cluster is 3. It is providing the statics about CPU, memory, disk usage. It also provides the statics about inbound and outbound of the network, top host by CPU, top host by memory. You can also look at host overview. How many processes are running? You can also look at the process by memory, like Java process is consuming around 21%. Similar way, Java process is consuming 7% CPU usage. that is statics for incoming traffic on ETH and loopback interface. Similar way, that is statics for outgoing traffic on ETH and loopback interface. You can also look at the container overview. You can filter containers by CPU usage. It also provides the process name that is consuming high CPU usage. Similar way, you can filter containers based on memory usage. It also provides the information what process is consuming high memory in a container. Let's explore few more dashboard. You can also use the metric beat Kubernetes dashboard. This dashboard provides Kubernetes cluster information like total number of deployment, available ports per deployment, like controller deployment has one port, core DNS deployment has two node, Nginx deployment has four ports, desired port 18, available port 18, unavailable port 0, unavailable ports per deployment. This information is very useful when you manage a large Kubernetes environment. You can explore more metric beat dashboard according your requirement. In this video, that's all. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.